Today, I will be teaching as to how to do a vector error correction model. The work file is on the screen. I have got three variables, x, y, and z. It is in log format. Even before doing VECM, it is essential to do a unit root test, and all the variables should be stationary at first difference. Unit root test has been already done in VAR, so that video can be seen later. Now we will move on to the analysis. First, select the target variable with the help of shift or control key and click the right tab. You will get open. From there, move on to as VAR. Let the VAR specification be as default and click OK. Then go to view. Scroll down to lag structure. From there, move on to lag length criteria. Let the lag specification be as default and click OK. So there are 5 criterions: LR, FPE, AIC, SC, and HQ. So based on LR, FPE, AIC, and HQ, these tests suggest for 2 lags, but SC suggests for 1 lag. So I'll be going with the majority, so I'll be using 2 lags for further analysis. Next, I have to go for the co-integration test. For that, click view, scroll down to co-integration test. Let 3 be as default, so already lag 2 is there, so we need not specify it once again, and then click OK. So the co-integration result appears. So based on trace test, it indicates one co-integrating equation at 0.05 level. So you find that it is significant here. In the case of max eigenvalue test, that also indicates one co-integrating equation at 0.05 level. So you find the p-value is less than 0.05. In certain cases, trace test will have one co-integrating equation, but max eigenvalue will not have any co-integrating equation. In that situation, you can carry on with VECM. Suppose the trace statistics as well as max eigenvalue doesn't have any co-integrating equation, then it is better to use the VAR model. The next part in the analysis is to explain the normalized co-integrating coefficient. So here, this is the target variable, that's why the value is 1. This is the y log of y log of z. While interpreting this co-integrating coefficient, you have to interpret in reverse. Now the sign here is positive, but while interpreting it become negative. Here it is negative, it has to be interpreted with positive value. 14.12 is the coefficient, in bracket is the standard error. Coefficient divided by the standard error will give you t statistics. Now we have to see how it has to be interpreted. This has been already typed, so you can just see on. This is the normalized co-integrating equation. The coefficient sign should be reverse. In the normalized co-integrating equation of Johansson model, which is representing the long run, lnx is the target variable, lny has a negative and significant impact on lnx in the long run. An increase in lny will lead to a decline in lnx. In the case of lnz, it is positive and significant. An increase in lnz will lead to an increase in lnx. So since z is negative, here we have written it as positive. Here you can see lny is positive, here it is. So this equation has to be interpreted in this format. Next, we will move on to the further analysis by closing down this, and with the help of right tab, click open. open as var. Here you have to click vector error correction. And later in the lag you have to minus 1, that is p minus 1. In VECM model, the variables need not be converted into first difference. It will be automatically converted into first difference. But in the case of var model, it is essential to convert the variables into first difference and then run the analysis. In the co-integration, the number of co-integrating in the study is 1. If you have got more than 1, it is better to use 1 for easy explanation. For VEC restriction, I don't have anything, so let everything be as default. I am getting back to basics. So with this, we'll click OK. So this will be your long run coefficient. This is your error correction term or speed of adjustment. And this is your short run coefficient. So D refers to first difference of X. So this L and X refers to lag 1. So difference, first difference of lag 1x. So this is how you have to understand. So the first one is the coefficient, in brackets it is standard error, and this is t statistics. This you can see over here. Now we'll go in for the interpretation of the ECT, that is the error correction term. Error correction coefficient gives the speed of adjustment within which the model will restore its equilibrium following any disturbances. The coefficients of ECT with LNX and LNY as dependent variable are negative and statistically significant, indicating that there is a convergence from short dynamics towards long run equilibrium. The adjustments coefficient were 0.02% and 0.01% respectively towards long run equilibrium in the case of disequilibrium situation. In the case of LNZ, the adjustment coefficient is positive but not significant, which indicates the lack of significant adjustment towards long run equilibrium in any disequilibrium situation. This is how you have to interpret your error correction coefficient. So you find that the LNX as well as LNY is significant, but Z is not significant because the T value is less than 2. Now for the long run coefficient as well as the short run coefficient, we have to estimate via equation. For that, click PROC, make system, order by variable. So my interest is only in X, so I'll be taking only the first equation. Copy it, go to quick, go on to estimate equation, paste it, and then click OK. So here C1 refers to the long run coefficient, C2 is LNX itself, C3, that is a coefficient of the coefficient 3 will be Y, and 4 will be Z, C5 will be constant or intercept. Now we have to see how it has to be explained. The long run coefficient C1 is negative and significant, which shows long run causality between LNY and LNZ to LNX. Coefficient should have a negative sign, showing the ability to bounce back to equilibrium. The positive sign indicates movement away from equilibrium. In the case of short run coefficient C2, a percentage increase in itself, that is LNX, will lead to a decline in LNX by 0.48%. In the case of C3, a percentage increase in LNY will lead to an increase in LNX by 1.7%. In the case of C4, a percentage increase in LNZ will lead to a decline in LNX by 0.67%. In the case of C5, it is constant or intercept. Now from 1 to 4, all the coefficients are significant. So here the adjusted square is say 36%. F is significant. Durbin-Watson is 2.0, so it is free from serial correlation. But still, it is necessary to check the residual diagnostics like normality, serial correlation and heteroscedasticity. These are done in the WAR model. You can just go through the video so that you will have a better idea. Now these are the pattern in which you have to interpret your results. Thank you for listening.